Let's move on to spheres. Now we will talk about volumes. Dare I try to draw a sphere? I guess I dare. Draw a circle. And then try to draw like the equator here. So yeah, I used to want to be a cartoonist when I was about 12 years old. And I made actually hundreds of cartoons back then. And I mimicked Peanuts, you know, Charlie Brown and Snoopy. Snoopy's very easy to draw, actually, if you practice enough. Charlie Brown is very hard to draw. It's really hard to get his head right. And yeah, I actually read a biography about Charles Schulz, the creator of Peanuts. And he's like, yeah, people just can't draw Charlie Brown. Charlie Brown's head is not a perfect sphere. A perfect sphere is easier to draw than Charlie Brown's head. Anyway, so choose your coordinate system so that the origin is at the center of the sphere. And you got, notice you've got three axes here. Say an x-axis going to the right there. A y-axis maybe going into the paper like that. And the third axis, I guess, let's call it the z-axis going straight up. Some people look at this and they just, you know, it just looks two-dimensional to them. Some people, oh yes, I see the three-dimensional picture here. Okay, you can see it, you can sort of feel it in your gut. That's a three-dimensional picture that I'm looking at. I'm not even trying to draw with perspective in the usual sense of the word. Okay, so what are we after here? So we're after the volume of the sphere. Volume of sphere. And I could do it as like finding the volume of 1/8 of the sphere, which would be like in the where x, y, and z are all positive, say here. But I think it's going to be simplest to find it the volume of a hemisphere, half of sphere, where just x is positive. So that's to the right here. And then double it. So let's do this as 2 times the volume of the hemisphere. We'll start by doing it with slices that have straight knives. And then the more fun way, we'll do it with a knife that's somehow spherical in shape. And somehow, if this is like a cake, we'll stick the knife inside the cake and slice. Of course, you can't literally do such a thing without somehow going into some higher dimension before you get the knife in there in reality. But in math, you can pretend you're doing it. You know, you can do things in math that you can't do in real life. Did you know you can travel faster than the speed of light? In math, in your mind, you can pretend you're traveling faster than the speed of light, even though you can't in reality. So many things you can do in math that you can't do in reality. Let's first slice with vertical slices perpendicular to the x-axis, a thin slice like this. So we're gonna have circular cross-section here. We are gonna need the formula for the area of a circle, which we just derived, pi r squared. Circular cross-section at location x. So I'm using x in two ways here, both as the label for the axis and this spot there, and a width, small width delta x. The small volume of this thin wafer, this thin hockey puck, is going to be approximately pi r squared, little r squared, times delta x. I'm using capital R again for the radius. see a delta x in here. You got to get everything in terms of x. I got to figure out how the radius of this thin disk depends on x. The equation of a sphere is x squared plus y squared plus z squared, if it's centered at the origin and has radius capital R, equals r squared. The distance formula does generalize to higher dimensions. And if you set y equal to 0, so you're pretending that you're in the xz plane here, and solve for z, that'll be the same as the radius. Z will be the same as the radius, will be square root of capital R squared minus x squared, which is the same radius as the circle. The same, well, it wasn't a radius in that problem, but it was the same, it was the same as the height in the circle example. Same as the height there is the radius of this thin disk. So plug that in here in place of r. Hey, and the square root's going to go away. We're actually going to get an easier integral to do. Even though it's a higher dimensional problem, the integral itself is going to be easier to do. Oops. I wanted to keep that a delta x here. So now let delta x go to 0. And poof, we get an integral. X goes from, look at the picture, 0 out to capital R, pi times capital R squared minus x squared dx. And yeah, we don't need a trig substitution there. Integrate with respect to x. Plug in the numbers. First plug in x equals r, then plug in x equals 0. That's a 2/3 r cubed. Lo and behold, we get 4/3 pi r cubed. Fun. Right? Happy, happy, happy. Let's do it in the even more fun way now. Sphere. Actually, when you do it this way, you don't have to use a coordinate system. Could. Whereas back here, we used thin rings, thin washers. Here we'd have to use thin spherical shells. We'd have to have a three-dimensional knife itself shaped like a sphere. That could be bigger or smaller. And we got to stick it inside this sphere to make our cuts. Dare I draw such a spherical shell? That's getting kind of dicey. Essentially, I draw another sphere inside here, but I have to imagine it's got a certain small width to it, like the crust of the earth or something. The spherical shell, let me just use words here. Spherical shell at radius r and width delta r is what I'm imagining being inside there, but I'm not really trying to draw. Imagine. Yeah, I could try, and maybe there are some people who would do a good job, but I'm afraid I'd just mangle it. But can you, in your mind, imagine such a thing? You got to imagine a sphere that has a small thickness to it, and it's inside this bigger sphere. And I can do it very small or very large. What is the volume of that thin spherical shell? What did I do back in the two-dimensional situation? I said, get a scissors out and cut the thin ring right there and unroll it so it looked like that. Can I do such a thing with a three-dimensional situation? Cut a spherical shell and unroll it? I could try. Sounds really difficult to literally do. But even if I can't literally imagine doing it, could I still approximate its volume? It would still be thin with delta R. What would its cross-sectional area be if I unrolled it, even if it didn't look like a sphere or a circle? Its cross-sectional area, whatever it looks like, should be the surface area of the sphere, 4 pi r squared. Which I haven't derived the formula for the surface area of a sphere. You can derive surface areas with integrals. We just haven't done it. It'd be the surface area 4 pi r squared times that small width. And the total volume then would be the sum of the little volumes, which would be approximately sums like that look like this, which, hey, once again, are Riemann sums. Let delta R go to zero. And the total volume of the sphere, which I need to forget, not forget multiplying by, no, I'm not multiplying by two like I did back up here. Sorry. You don't have to multiply by two here. In fact, you'll get the wrong answer if you do. Here I'm imagining doing this for the entire sphere all at once. So I'm integrating 4 pi r squared dr, little r goes from 0 to capital R. And once again, just like the other case, the answer just pops out like nothing. There we go, 4/3 pi r cubed. Something interesting to think about in both of these examples. Let me go back to just using little r's. The derivative with respect to little r of the volume, use little r, is the surface area. And the derivative with respect to R of the area of a circle is its circumference. We were really kind of using those facts in these easier derivations in doing antiderivatives. Integrate 2 pi R, you get pi R squared. Integrate 4 pi R squared, you get 4/3 pi R cubed. Is that an accident? The answer is no. Yeah, the derivative of the volume with respect to the radius is the surface area. The derivative of the area with respect to the radius is the circumference. And it's not an accident. Interesting. I wonder whether that generalizes to other kinds of objects. And the answer is yes, it does, though the formulas for volumes and or surface areas of those other kinds of objects could be not so nice and uniform. Spheres, circles and spheres are very nice, right?